Do you have as many Google reviews as you should? Today we're going to talk about ways to increase your Google reviews and get much more effective results. Hey guys, I'm Praz Murthy, CFO and co-founder at Dr. Multimedia, and today we're going to talk about easy ways to increase your number of Google reviews. Before we get started, be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel to be the first to know about new videos just like these that come out. And also, if you haven't already, do subscribe to our email list, send us a message through our website, and we'll be able to send you emails every time we release one of these new videos, so you'll be first to know, and you can ask us all kinds of questions. The response so far has been fantastic, so we can't wait to share more videos with you coming up. So Google reviews are a huge topic these days because they show up in Google search results, they show up on your maps, and more patients are making decisions as to what practices to call first based on the reviews. We talked about this in some of our early videos, but if you didn't see those, in your map pack on Google, you often see three options. And even without knowing anything else about those options, if someone has a 3.5 star rating and someone else has a 5.0 rating, most other things being equal, we're going to call the one with a 5.0 rating first. So in a lot of ways, the Google reviews are forming our actions and our first impressions. And this is before people even see your website and learn about you and watch your videos. It's just that gut reaction. You don't want to go in with a bad impression. So we could talk for hours about the importance of Google reviews, but today we're going to look at five different ways to build your Google reviews and effective tips and tricks. One way to get more reviews, and the most effective way, in my opinion, is to ask. There's all these fancy tools out there that will send automated text messages or email blasts or follow-ups to surveys to try to get reviews. I've never found anything that beats just asking person to person, human to human, and making it an appeal between your staff or you and the patient. Asking at every opportunity. But the problem is, you have to be consistent and you have to be relentless when it comes to asking. You want every patient that comes to your practice to be asked if they had a good experience. If not, you obviously would want to know so that you could correct the issue. And if so, you want to see if they have 10 or 15 seconds to leave you a Google review. And from there, it comes to you and your staff to know how to quickly help someone get to your Google page, leave a review, and be on their way. But if you ask consistently, you will find that your Google reviews will grow every week, every month, and when you look back over the course of a year, you'll have way more reviews than you would have if you weren't asking. The biggest mistake people make, however, is they ask infrequently. So they ask people sometimes. They ask when they're not too busy at the front desk. They ask when they think it's surefire that someone's gonna wanna leave them a review. They hesitate to ask if they're not sure. All of those are a recipe for failure when it comes to increasing your Google reviews, because no matter how many people you ask, most of them are going to say no, and that's okay. It's expected that most people that you ask will not leave a review, which is why it's so important to ask everybody, because if you ask 10 people in a day and you get one yes, that's a huge success. But if it takes you a month to ask 10 people, you're still only going to get one yes, and you're only going to grow by one review a month, which just isn't enough these days.